Planning a landfill brings together a diverse team of engineers, hydrologists, geologists, seismic experts, and others who determine the site's potential impact on groundwater, air quality, and the surrounding community. Their findings ultimately determine the landfill's location or footprint and its airspace or maximum capacity. The first step in preparing a new cell involves earthwork, excavating and grading the site at a slight angle so liquid that percolates through the soil and waste, commonly known as leachate, runs toward the center of the landfill where it can be filtered and safely drained. The leachate, basically salty water, is then collected and used in water trucks for dust control. Once the ground is prepared, multiple layers of protection are rolled out over the earth.
To show you what's involved when we construct the landfill, this has clay inside of it. This is what's called the GCL. This is the first layer to go down after we've done the earthwork. This is filled with a highly expansive clay. If any water hits this, it expands and seals any holes or punctures that might exist down there.
The GCL covers the entire landfill like a blanket. To protect this clay layer from damage, it's covered with a sheet of flexible, high-density polyethylene plastic. 60 millimeters thick and as hard as a roofing shingle, the plastic is rolled out in wide sheets and welded together in place. To test the weld, welded sections of plastic are cut from the sheet and stress tested to ensure the strength of the weld. Once the plastic liner is welded in place, it is covered with a highly durable 16-ounce weight geotextile fabric. The fabric is rolled out in sheets and sewn together in place using an automated sewing machine. The geotextile provides a heavy-duty protective layer above the hard plastic liner beneath it. The fabric is permeable, but is capable of blocking particles that might scratch and wear on the plastic. The next step in the layering process is gravel, which is spread 12 inches deep on top of the geotextile. The gravel is important because it allows liquid, such as rainfall, to flow toward the center of the landfill where drainage can occur. Once the gravel is spread, yet another layer of 16-ounce geotextile fabric is rolled into place, this time intended to help keep the gravel clean by preventing fines, small pieces of construction debris, from entering and clogging the gravel layer. 2 feet of fine-grained dirt is spread atop the last layer of geotextile. This layer, because it is fine-grained, is more resistant to penetration from wood and other debris. It also provides an operational layer on which larger equipment can move freely. Lastly, on top of the fine-grained dirt, 2 more feet of soil is applied. This creates the driving layer, ready for trucks bringing debris into the landfill. Like a new car, the landfill is broken in slowly, at first accepting only select waste, shorter pieces and softer materials that create an additional layer of protection for the liner. The life of this landfill is 30 years. Once it's closed and covered, the site will be monitored for more than 30 years and will be landscaped and turned over to the public for use as a park, riding stable, motocross track, or some other use, as have hundreds of landfills across the country.